What's going on, guys? It's your boy Kyle McGuire from United Softwash, and today just want to jump on here real quick and we're going to discuss four rookie roof cleaning mistakes I see happen all the time, guys. If you're on Facebook, I'm sure you see these questions pop up all the time and you're like, dang, you smoking rocks, my dude? People out here making crazy mistakes. So we're going to talk about the four biggest rookie mistakes I see when it comes to roof cleaning. Let's jump right into it. Peace. What's going on, everybody? It's Kyle McGuire from United Softwash.
What you doing, baby?
Making coffee in this Italian coffee maker that you broke because you're a caveman.
We're making some good progress on this roof. We just did this portion right here above the garage. Guys, number one, the biggest mistake I see all the time on videos, it will make you cringe, is someone with a pressure washer pushing a surface cleaner up on a roof. Whether it's a red barrel tile or it's an asphalt shingle, it don't matter. The right way and the safe way to wash someone's roof is not with a pressure washer. You are not blasting the roof to get off that organic growth. What we are doing in this industry is something called soft washing, something that I teach in my exterior cleaning course that we do. Soft washing a roof, it's a low pressure chemical cleaning application that it's a chemical that we apply to the roof to neutralize the organic growth. That's what's going to remove the black streaks and the unsightly things that you see on the roof, not pressure, guys. So that's the biggest mistake I see. Don't let me catch you up there on a roof with a surface cleaner, all right? So you're just going to rip off years of someone's lifespan of the roof, the shingles, by ripping off all of the granules, or you're going to increase the likelihood of cracking somebody's barrel tiles up there by going up there with the pressure. We rely on the chemical to do the work for us, guys. Let's work smarter, not harder. So that's number one, using pressure to clean a roof. Don't be a clown. Peace. All right, guys, number two, and I don't know where y'all thought y'all could do this. I don't think nobody's out there putting videos about downstreaming roofs. I don't see it. I can't find the information nowhere, so I don't know what makes a lot of y'all think you could just get a pressure washer and a downstream injector and start spraying a roof and taking off those black, really dark black streaks caused by that gloeocapsid magma. It's not going to happen, all right? So in some cases, guys, and it's a very small case where it's like really, really faint streaks on the roof, potentially, yes, you could clean it with a downstream injector, but guys, in 99% of the cases, you need a dedicated system, whether you're using a blend manifold or you're just batch mixing. And I don't care if you're using a 12-volt air diaphragm, gas roof pump, booster, all of these systems can pull a hot enough mix to clean a roof. But a downstream injector, you're just going to fall short and flat on your face 9 times out of 10, all right? So don't be the guy in the group or in these Facebook groups that gets online and they post a picture of a roof before and after and there's no difference. And they're like, what am I doing wrong, guys? I downstreamed this roof. I can't tell y'all how many people have called me asking questions about roof cleaning. And I don't ever advocate just calling me for the hell of it either for information because, you know, I'm not selling my time. I don't do consulting, but people still call me, guys. And I try to help because I'm a nice guy. But I'm like, you can't downstream a roof, guys. You're just not going to get the results you want. So don't be that guy. Don't be a clown. Don't go out there and try to downstream a roof. What's really crazy is people that do that and people that fall for this rookie mistake, and then they go on Facebook in like panic mode, those type people have went to a customer, sold themselves as a professional, and charged this customer for their service that they have no idea what they're doing. So don't be that person, all right? Don't use a downstream injector. That's number two. Let's go to number three. All right, guys. Number three, huge mistake that I see all the time. Countless times I'm online and I see where people have messed up people's plants or people have actually messed up the building that they're doing a roof wash on. Very easy to prevent these types of things, guys. It's not rocket science. We're spraying sodium hypochlorite on these roofs at a very hot mix, so we want to ensure that we're doing all types of things to protect the customer's property. Now, when it comes to plants, don't be the guy that goes out there and burns up everybody's plants. It's very easy to mitigate this. In most cases, you could just pre-saturate the plant and keep them wet with, have a ground person on the ground, spraying the plants with water the whole time. That way they're staying wet. Especially if you have delicate plants, those need to be kept wet the whole time. Or in some cases, you want to cover them with some painter's plastic or some Tyvek plastic and cover the plants. That way they don't get that overspray and contamination on them. So that's plants. Hydrate the plants, keep them wet the whole time, invest in a technician to be out there helping you, spraying the plants down. And if you don't have a technician or an additional set of hands to help you out, don't do the whole roof when you're washing the roof. Work in small portions of the roof. That way, every minute or so, you could come down from the ladder, you could saturate the plants in the surrounding area, and you could keep their plants safe and not burn them up. All right, now when it comes to the building, guys, depending on what your surface is, you could have some adverse reactions if any of that overspray gets onto the building. Especially if you're washing a house that may not have gutters. That's just asking for more problems, guys. So one easy thing you could do, just like a house wash, is do a test spot on your painted surface. Go out there, get a hot mix. You could use straight 12.5% bleach. Go somewhere that's not easily seen, maybe underneath their back deck or behind a bush, maybe behind the AC unit. Do a test spot to ensure that you're not going to have an adverse reaction to that sodium hypochlorite and surfactant on their house. So give it a couple minutes. If everything looks good and you could rinse it off, just rinse off that sodium hypochlorite and there was no adverse reaction, you know that 9 times out of 10 you're going to be okay in that scenario. But if you go out there and you have a house that has organic paint, you're probably going to have issues if you get some overspray on it and you didn't do your due diligence and do a test spot. Takes just a couple minutes, guys, and it could save you thousands of dollars, guys. So don't be lazy. Go out there, be a professional, be the person that you say you are to your customers, and take the right preventative measures to ensure that you're protecting their property. Last but not least, guys, is number 4. This is the biggest rookie mistake I see, and that is expectation management. You have to talk to your customers, and you have to educate the customers depending on how bad their roof is degraded. The degradation on the roof caused by the Glowiocaps and Magma, or maybe it's even gotten to the point where it's moss. And whenever you spray your roof cleaning solution, just like we talked about earlier, we're not using pressure, we're using a chemical cleaning solution on the roof. Once we apply that, its purpose is to neutralize the organic growth. So it's going to turn that green moss to that cotton white color. And in most cases, you're still going to see that at the end of the day after you clean and wash the roof. You have to wait on the sun to come out, prolonged UV exposure, maybe some rain to dry out all of that organic growth and make it real brittle, and the rain will help wash it away over time. But that comes with expectation management. I see it all the time, guys, especially in Facebook groups. People go out there and nuke a roof that has moss all over it, and they think the moss is just going to disappear and melt away like the black streaks do. Not going to happen. You're going to still have that organic growth up there if you're not blasting it with pressure and you're doing it the right way, soft washing. So expectation management, talk to the customer, educate them about what results they're going to see whenever you're done. Then you're going to avoid a lot of those hot questions whenever you get done, because I'm sure if you don't educate the customer, they're going to be like, what the hell? I just paid you $2,000 and I still got white moss all over my roof. So talk to your customer about the results that they're going to see in their given situation, guys. I hope this helps. That's 4 rookie mistakes I see all the time and how to prevent them. I hope that helped, guys. We're rolling right now. It is the middle of the month. We're doing real good. We're on a roll. Hope everybody's doing good. Give me a couple minutes. I'm going to go look at my calendar, and we're going to announce another introduction to exterior cleaning class. We're going to have it on a Friday, just to give you a little overview of what it is before I give you the dates and you sign up. It is $350 a person. We're going to go over how to safely and properly wash a building or a house, as well as how to properly and safely wash a roof. Then we're going to go over flat surfaces like concrete driveways and patios and sidewalks. We'll go over all those things in the classroom, all while talking about application methods. How are we going to apply our chemical, whether it's 12 volt system, or I'm sorry, a dedicated soft wash system like 12 volt or air diaphragm. We'll go over using an X-Jet, as well as we'll go over doing downstream injection. We will also do these things in the field. Whenever we go out there, I have a house picked out. We're gonna do a house wash. We're gonna do a partial roof cleaning at another property, as well as do a concrete driveway and sidewalks. We'll also talk about property protection. What mitigating factors are we placing? Are we ensuring that we're doing to protect the property? We'll talk about the chemicals that we're using, how we mix these chemicals, what ratios we need, what things we need to do to the property to ensure that we don't catch it on fire or we don't mess up paint and things like that. So if that sounds like something you're interested in, an introduction to exterior cleaning course, it was an absolute success about a month ago, and I'm looking forward to doing it again. We're going to have 7 slots at $350 a slot, so let me go get the dates for you. Peace. All right, guys. Your boy just checked the schedule, and June 25th, it is a Friday. We're going to start at 9 a.m. in Garner, North Carolina. This class is going to be first come, first serve, guys. I talked to a lot of people about holding some slots for a class that we were going to do last month, ended up not doing it. And since then, I've lost y'all's information. Unfortunately, I had some water intrusion on my phone. So this go round for this class is first come, first serve. Last time it sold out in probably 2 hours. So just give me a ring. I'll process your payment. We'll get you on the schedule for the class. But I hope everybody's doing great. Your boy's a little tired. Just did some commercial work today and a residential job. Now I got to prep the truck for tomorrow. Got a big day tomorrow. I think I got 4 jobs on the schedule. And that's it, guys. We're just getting after it. Trying to make that money while we can. Get it while the getting's good. God bless everybody. I'll talk to you soon. Peace.